Hello and welcome to day 14 of this book, Frameworks Volume 2, God by Paul Blackham. Day 14, The Power of Almighty God. The Power of Almighty God. Yesterday in day 13, we were looking at the crucified God and how in the weakness and the death of the cross, we see revealed for us the reality of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. But it's not just that God is weak, although at that moment he was weak. He is the Almighty God. Again and again, that's one of the titles used, often for the Father and also sometimes for the Son. The Lord Almighty, who rules with power and strength. We read these words in 2 Chronicles chapter 20. Jehoshaphat, in front of the temple, declares this. O Lord, God of our fathers, are you not the God who is in heaven? You rule over all the kingdoms of the nations. Power and might are in your hands, and no one can withstand you. He is the powerful one, the almighty one, who rules over the nations and over every kingdom. But you remember how we talked about the philosophical terms and how so often they fall short of the reality of what is shown us in the Bible of how God reveals himself. And one of those terms is that term omnipotent. God's omnipotence, omni, all, potent, powerful, the all-powerfulness of God. Now, from 2 Chronicles, we clearly see that God is all-powerful. But there's so much more to say to about God's strength and about God's might. And we see in Jesus' life, as he lives on earth, as he comes down as the Son of God, taking on human form, we see how he interacts and engages with the Father. And that shows us kind of insight into the nature of God himself. What do we see about the power of Jesus? In Matthew 11, we read that all things have been committed to the Son. That the Father is powerful. He is the God of heaven, and he is rules over all. He is the Lord of heaven and earth. And all things have been committed to Jesus, he says. All things have been committed to me by my Father. You see how the power flows from the Father, who is Lord of heaven and earth, and it flows down to the Son. And the Son, then, we see, wields that power in the strength of the Spirit. He never does things of his own accord and of his own strength, but does what work by the Spirit. One of the great passages for understanding and seeing kind of into the realities of the divine is in the book of Daniel. In the book of Daniel, there's all sorts of visions, and there's one in Daniel chapter 7, where you have the Ancient of Days sat on his throne, on his seat. The Ancient of Days being the Father here, and then the Son of Man, one of the titles for Jesus, the Son of Man approaches, and the Father gives, you know, the Ancient of Days, the one who wields all power and authority, he gives authority, glory, and sovereign power to this Son of Man. And so again, we see how there's power that flows from the Father to the Son. Yes, the Father is almighty. He is all-powerful. Yes, the Son is almighty. He is all-powerful. And yet neither of them wields that power self-sufficiently, self-servingly. Each one, the Father gives that power to the Son, and the Son receives and uses that power for the service of the Father. In the words of Jesus, when he's on earth, in John chapter 5, Jesus says this: by myself I can do nothing, says the Son of Man, who's been given all authority, power, and might. By myself I can do nothing. I judge only as I hear, and my judgment is just, for I seek not to please myself, but him who sent me. A little bit later in John chapter 12, we read, for I did not speak of my own accord, but the Father who sent me commanded me what to say and how to say it. Whatever I say is just what the Father has told me to say. And then one more from John chapter 4. My food, said Jesus, is to do the will of him who sent me and to finish his work. And so again and again and again in the Bible, we see the Almighty Father entrusting work to his Son, who has received power and might from him. And Jesus uses that power not to do his own will, but to do the will of the Father. And he does it not of his own strength, but he goes in the power of the Spirit as the anointed one, filled with the Spirit, carrying out the Father's work. Isn't this amazing as a wonderful picture of power in this world when so often we see corrupted power, when we see people using strength for themselves, and when those who do have strength seek to do everything themselves rather than entrusting it to others and enabling and strengthening others to do good works too. Here we see this beautiful picture of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit working together, serving each other, and drawing us into that life as well. And so as we are called to serve God, we don't do it of our own strength. We do it in the strength of the one who calls us. And we do what the Father asks us. We do it in the strength that the Spirit gives, serving Christ the King. There's no room for self-serving. There's no room for self-sufficiency here. Yes, the Father is almighty. Yes, the Son is almighty. Yes, we'd say that the Spirit also is almighty. Each serving, needing the other, working together as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. This is the power of Almighty God.